Hey guys, so today I'm gonna go ahead and show you my product empties. So I've been collecting this big old thing of trash right here. Or not trash, but products I have used up. So beauty trash and slash recycle. You know what I mean, I'm a big recycler. And give you guys kind of like mini reviews, like if I like the product, if I don't like the product, like if it was worth it, if it wasn't working, etc., etc. And at the end of this video, I'm gonna go ahead and share with you guys some things that I just returned. Like, I didn't even wanna use them up. They were not worth it. Like, I just had to take them back to the store. The first thing is a Wet Ones. I just use the Sensitive Skin Formula. I use these to wipe off my makeup. You can just kinda see like the makeup smudges because I do my makeup in my room. So I don't have a, you know, wet towel or anything to like wipe off my hands if they get messy. So I just use Wet Ones. Next, two things are Cetaphil moisturizing creams. I love this stuff. You guys can get this at Costco. I think a two pack is like 14 bucks or something. I think it's like 11 bucks for just one in the store. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong with the price because my mom always just picks them up when she goes to Costco, but I'm in love with this stuff. It's a really, really heavy cream. I've already repurchased these. I just will forever like that stuff. So if you guys don't like heavy creams, you're not gonna like that, but I just like it a lot, especially in the winter time because my skin is so dry and it just moisturizes it, and it's non-comedogenic, fragrance-free, and dermatologist recommended. So bam, 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 can't like beat that. Next two things are Alba Botanica Hawaiian Natural Shampoo and Conditioner. This is in the gardenia ones. If you guys have been watching the videos lately, or my videos, not the videos, you guys will know that I'm obsessed with the smell of gardenia, and obviously this is living proof. We bought the Plumeria ones, so I already repurchased this. I really like the formula. It strips out, or the shampoo strips out like the crap in my hair without stripping out all of the oils, all the natural oils, so I don't feel like completely dry afterwards, but I do need to follow up with a conditioner, and I like this conditioner a lot. It is frizz-free, it's just like it claims, and I really like this stuff. Plus, it smells amazing. The next thing that's almost empty is a Bath & Body Works Pleasures Night Blooming Jasmine Body Lotion. There's just a little teeny bit in here. I'll probably finish this up tonight or something. I really like using this smell at night. If I were to repurchase this exact scent, I would repurchase it in the cream version because I hear that the lotions have parabens and the cream, like the taller cream ones, don't. And I really like the triple body cream better than the lotions anyway, but I really do like this scent. The next thing is a Bobo's Remy Brings Back Hair to Life Leave-In Conditioner. I used to like this back when I wore like clip-in extensions. I really liked it for them, but I don't like this for my current extensions. I have found better things, and I will not be repurchasing it. It was kind of expensive. It was $10, $9.99. I just found it at a local beauty supply store, and I mean, it just wasn't anything special that I couldn't like find at a cheaper price. Another thing that I have used up is an Onyx Professional Salon Formula Nail Polish Remover. I actually really like the formula of this, but I hated the pump. Like, it's really messy. I did a review a long time ago for this because Onyx Brands actually sent this to me, and I think I mentioned how the pump was really messy back then too. Like, it just spewed everywhere, and I wish they would fix that because I would repurchase this if they fixed the packaging, but I just am not a fan of the pump. But I do like the formula, so you win some, you lose some. Another item that I used up is the Blemish Control Cleanser by SkinScript. With 2% salicylic acid and 2% glycolic acid with tea tree oil. I like this stuff. Jeremy actually finished up the rest of this, but I liked it. I just didn't like it as much as my current skincare, I guess. And it is kind of pricey, so I'm trying out Michael Todd products currently, so I'm gonna try and, you know, see how I feel about that before I repurchase SkinScript things. I did like them while I was using them though. Next thing is a Tresemme Fresh Start Dry Shampoo for oily straight to normal hair. I did not like this stuff at all. I really like the Suave one, but this one just wasn't a fan. There's still a little bit in there and I just can't bring myself to use it. I don't know, there's not anything in particular that I really liked about it, and I just wasn't a fan at all. The next thing that I've used up is a Breath of Fresh Air Toner Water by Lush. I like this toner, but again, I'm just trying other things. I really didn't like the pump though. Again, this is like a packaging problem. I liked the actual formula of the toner, but like, I like to spray my toners or put a little bit on a cotton sheet, and like, this pump, like, put out too much. So if I sprayed it, it was like too much. And if I put too much on, like, if I put some on a little cotton pad, it would spray too much. And so I'm like, just didn't want to use as much as it made me use. You know what I mean? And this stuff is kind of expensive. So I wasn't trying to, I'm just not trying to repurchase it. The next two things are also by Lush's, the Big Conditioner and a sample of the Big Shampoo. I liked the shampoo. It was just a little bit different, I guess, for me. I won't buy the actual full size. It was like, I don't know how to describe it. My girl Jennifer, or iHeart Makeup 610, she loves this stuff, but I just didn't like it. I don't know. Like, I just didn't feel like my hair was clean. It kind of set it up, but not really. And I know that shampoos, you don't want them to set up too much because then there's like, that's a sign of sulfates and whatnot, but I just didn't like it. I'm not going to buy the full version. And again, I did not like the Big Conditioner. Oh my God, this like completely ruined my, extensions. These are Brazilian straight extensions and they're pretty pricey, and this stuff, like, I don't even know. It did not detangle, did not condition. It just left it with like this nasty it just was so gross. It left it like with this nasty like film on top, and I hated it. Like, ew, I just won't. I thought maybe it was me, but no, I reused the whole entire thing. Or I didn't reuse the whole thing. I used it like 3 or 4 times and it was just no. Not buying them. The next thing is a sample. This is an Azulene eye cream. This stuff totally broke my skin out around my eye. Pretty sure I got like a few different little bumps on my eye because of this stuff. My girl Mallory and I were at Whole Foods and they had these samples and I was like, ooh, yay, eye cream, because I'm always down to try new eye cream. But no, just no. I'm not going to buy this. It was just, it was bad. Like, it just, like, it totally broke out around my eyes. I've never had that experience. And it felt dry around my eyes too. So I'm not going to be purchasing it. I didn't even finish the sample. It was just disgusting. Here's another sample. This is a Naked Skin sample from Sephora. I really, really enjoyed this foundation. I have too many foundations right now, but I think I will end up purchasing this. I can do a full review when I do purchase it. I am an 8.0. I just really enjoyed the formulation of it and it gave good coverage. And yeah, if you guys haven't tried this out, go to Sephora and get a sample. Another one is the Shikai All Natural Hand and Body Lotion in, you guessed it, gardenia. Like, seriously, I'm so predictable. This is kind of ridiculous, but I really like this. It is a creamier lotion and I really, really enjoy the smell. It lasts all day. I have since repurchased this. It smells amazing. The next few things are candles. I actually went through 2 of these Market Peach ones. It smells so good. I'm not like a big peachy person, if that made any sense. Like, I'm not like a big peach smelling person. What am I saying? I'm not a big peach scent person. That makes more sense. But I really like the smell of this candle. It burned really, really nicely, and I got these for free. I actually had another one as well that I also used up, but I had to throw it away because the glass broke, and that's just all sorts of dangerous. So I had to throw that one away, but I really enjoyed that candle. And then I also finally used up Autumn. I really liked burning this in the fall time. I just, when the seasons start to change, I just like usually put the old candles aside and like save them for the season again, because I just don't like burning things out of season. I know that makes me sound crazy, but it's true. But I love this scent and I will repurchase it. The next thing is a Got to Be Guardian Angel Heat Protectant Spray. This is my Holy Grail Heat Protectant. I love this stuff. It it protects up to 425 degrees, and I love the smell. It kind of smells like men's cologne, so if you're not into that, then just fair warning, but I do like it. It's inexpensive. You can get it at the drugstore, and it protects my hair. Another empty is the Shea Moisture Curl and Style Milk. I like this for my natural hair. I really liked it too, I guess, for this hair as well, but back when I had curly Brazilian hair, it was better. But I love, love, love the smell. There's no parabens or anything in it, so I don't know. I really like the formulation. Oh my gosh, you guys, I almost forgot to mention the returns that I did this quarter. So I returned the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. I used to love it, and I don't know what it was. Like, maybe I've just found other things that are better, but I absolutely hated it this time. I like couldn't find the right color for me, and I like exchanged it 2 or 3 times, and I just hated the formula. I don't know. I just don't know. I couldn't get myself to like it. It didn't blend very easily at all. It like looked like I had concealer on, you know what I mean? I wasn't a fan. The other thing I returned was the Hello Kitty perfume by Sephora. I ordered it online because it was on sale and it smelled like, I did not like the smell at all. It just smelled way too powdery. I couldn't stand it. So I had to return that. I'm sorry, Hello Kitty. I love you, but I did not love your perfume. Another thing I returned was also a Sephora purchase. It's the Philosophy Micro Delivery Peel. And I was doing chemical peels back in early winter. And I bought the micro delivery peel because I thought maybe I could do it at home and like it would give me like good results. All the results online said that they were, you know, they got rid of their hyperpigmentation and stuff, and although it did make my skin smooth, it didn't get rid of my scars, which is the whole point of me doing it. I got, or I used it like for about a month, like once a week for a month, and it just wasn't giving me any results at all, so I was like, bye. It was like $75, so I had to take it back. Another thing that probably most people are gonna be really surprised that I returned, but I absolutely did not like it at all. It's a 10. Miracle spray, and supposedly it does all these things for hair, and I just didn't like it. Like, I like the smell and everything, but I just didn't like the formula. It just weighed my hair down, and I just wasn't a fan. I had to return it for the price. I just wasn't impressed. So that went back to Fred Meyer. And last but not least, another makeup item I returned is the Andrea Lash Adhesive. So it kind of looks like the one that I just recently purchased by Ardell. That's and it also looks like the Revlon one, but it was crap. Like, it wouldn't even hold my lashes down. I used it in multiple different ways. I hated it. It didn't dry fast. No. No, thank you. So that is it for my empties and return video. If you guys like this video, then thumbs it up so I know to keep doing them. I might, again, have to start doing them more often because I'm just like staring at all the stuff that I have right now, and it's just like really, my anxiety is kicking in, and now I have to go clean this. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to follow me on Keek, Instagram, and Twitter, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.